Hello everyone, my name is Esha and welcome to MATLAB Helper. Today we are going to know how to implement Euler's method using MATLAB. So let's just get started. So let us first understand what Euler's method does. If you can see the graph in front of you here, we have a blue curve, which is the solution curve, and we have an initial point x naught and y naught on that curve. We know just this one point, and our aim is to find the point x1, y1 on the same solution graph. What Euler's method does is, it draws a line tangent to the solution curve, and on that tangent line, it moves a distance h, which is the step size, such that you go ahead and find the point x1, y1, which is a close approximation to the similar point on the solution curve. Now again, you move the by distance h, again on the tangent line, such that you find the point x2, y2 on the solution curve, which is an approximation to the solution curve, and so on and so forth. So what are the important things we need for this method are, first is the slope of the tangent, the slope of the red line given here, the step size h. Now the step size is recommended to be as small as possible to get a very close approximation to the solution curve. And the third one is the initial condition, which is the x naught, y naught. So we are going to see a basic RC circuit example implementing the Euler's method in MATLAB. So let's just go to the MATLAB code. So this is our MATLAB code here. What I have done here is first initialize all my values, the resistance, capacitor, constant voltage, initial time t equals 0, final time t equals 1, and the initial condition given to us is charge at the capacitor is 0 when time is 0. What we have to do is find the charge at the capacitor when time is 1. I'm going to do that in 10 steps, and my h, which is the step size, is going to be 1 by 10, which is 0.1. In the for loop here, what I have done is use the Euler's approximation method here, and for 10 steps of mine, with each step incremented by h, I evaluate the function. And just to verify our answer with the true solution, I have also plotted the true solution here. So let us just run the program and look at the graph. You can see both the graphs are so close. So as we can see, the red one is Euler's and the blue one is the exact solution to the curve. And there is not much difference, and which is not surprising because Euler's method is a brilliant way to find solutions to first order differential methods. And if you wish to look at the values of the table here, we also have the values here. At time t equals 0, Euler's value is 0, exact value is 0. At time t equals 1, you can see such small difference, you know. So this is a really great way to find a solution to first order differential equations. You can try that yourself. And I hope you like this video. Do like this video if you found it helpful. And if you have any query, post it in comment or get in touch with us. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching.